Combat Arena, Clash of Champions, is an exciting game pitting dueling heroes against one another in no-holds-barred combat. Hello, and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint Lieutenant Castus from the Combat Arena box set. So the first thing that we need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we've used McCrag Blue Spray. The first paint that we're going to use is McCrag Blue from the pot. The reason for this is that it has a slightly different finish to the spray, so if we make any mistakes, it'll be really easy for us to tidy up later. So let's get some McCrag Blue onto the palette. So I'm just going to get a dollop here, get it onto the palette, get a little bit of water because you want to thin it out. Yeah, that's nice. And I'm just testing it there and then getting my brush to a nice sharp point just by rolling it while getting off the excess. And then what we want to do is start to get that all over the power armor. Don't worry about being too neat at this point because you will be painting over the other details later. Just make sure to keep your paint nice and thin. And once it's dry, go back in and do a second layer. And with that step complete, we now need to do the first load of the rest of the base paints. And for this, we're going to be using Corax White, Corvus Black, Mephiston Red, and Zandri Dust. So let's get some Corax White onto the palette. I'm just going to get a dollop here of Corax White, get it onto the palette a little bit more, and get some water just to thin it out. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Maybe just a little bit more. Yeah, that's perfect. And then twisting my brush to a nice sharp point. And then what we want to do with this is that we're going to pick out the inside of the shield here. But first of all, I'm going to show you how to do the lieutenant markings on the helmet. So what we want to do is just paint a white line just down the inside of the helmet there. And then one on this side here. Just rough at this moment, all the way down to the brow. Don't worry about that mistake there. We'll just tidy that up with McCrag Blue. And then we're going to paint in this whole section. Just keeping the paint nice and thin. And you're probably going to need to do a few layers of this. So just let the paint dry before going back over it. With that stage complete, we're now going to use Corvus Black to pick out all of the black details. And you're looking to pick out the ribbings in between the armor, the gun casing, and the inside of the shield. Just take your time when doing this, and if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with the previous layers. And with that stage complete, we now need to move on to the red details. And for this, we're going to be using Mephiston Red. So what we're looking to do is to pick out the red stripe of the helmet. So as you see here, like I did with the white, I'm just going to draw a line down the center just to give me a marker. So just there, like that. And then on the other side, like that. And then I'm just going to fill in this section in red. And once I've done with this, I just need to pick out the wax seals, the handle of the sword, as well as the eye lenses. With the red details picked out, we now need to use Zandri Dust to pick out the tabard. And there we go. With that stage complete, we now need to pick out the rest of the base details. And for this, we're going to be using Rakarth Flesh, Mournfang Brown, Lead Belcher, and Retributor Armor. So let's get some Rakarth Flesh onto the palette. I'm just going to get a dollop here, get it onto the palette, get a little bit more, get some water just to thin it out. Yeah, that's good. Get my brush to a nice sharp point just by rolling it. And then what I want to do is start picking out all the parchment that you see on the model. With the parchment picked out, we're now going to use Mournfang Brown to pick out all the leather details. Just take your time when doing this and make sure not to get any of the paint on the previously painted details. However, if you do, don't worry about it. You can easily just tidy up with the previous layers. With that stage complete, we're now going to pick out all the silver metallic details using lead belcher. If you get confused where these are, just remember to check the box art. The next thing that we need to do is to fill in all of the gold metallic details, and for this, we're using Retributor armor. Just take your time when doing this, and as always, if you make any mistakes, don't worry, you can just tidy up with the previous colors. With that stage complete, all the gold details are now finished. What we need to do next is to change our water pot because we don't want to get any of those metallic flakes into the rest of our paints. Once you've done that, we're going to move on to doing the shade paints. And for this, we're going to be using Drakenoff Nightshade, Agarax Earthshade, and Nuln Oil. So let's get some Drakenoff Nightshade onto the paintbrush. So I'm just going to load up on this paint here, get it onto my brush. That's good. And then what I want to do is start to paint that Drakenoff Nightshade all over the blue areas of the armor. Just taking care when doing this not to get it on any of the other details. However, if you do, just tidy up with the previous layers. And with that stage complete, we now need to apply Agarax Earthshade over all the gold details, the leather, the tabard, and the purity seals. With that stage complete, you can see where we've picked out all the details using Agarax Earthshade. What we need to do next is use Nuln Oil and apply that over all the silver metallic and black details, as well as the red leather on the sword handle. And with that stage complete, the model is now fully shaded. What we need to do next is focus on doing the base. And for this, we're going to be using astrogranite debris and Nuln Oil. So let's get some astrogranite debris onto our texture tool. So I'm just going to use the large scoop end of the texture tool here to get some of the astrogranite out. And what we want to do is use the large flat end just to put it onto the base. Change to the small end and start pushing the astrogranite around on the base. Don't worry about getting too much of it onto the feet of the model, because if you do, it just helps to tie the model in with the base. Once you finish covering the entire base, just remember to let it dry for around an hour, just to allow the texture to take effect before doing anything else. With the texture paint now dry, the next thing that we need to do is apply Nuln Oil all over it. And with that stage complete, Lieutenant Castus is now finished. All that's left to do is paint the rim of the base. And for this, we've used Corvus Black. With the base completed and the rim painted, Lieutenant Castus is ready to march into the arena and defeat all those who stand before him. So there are just a couple of things to remember. When applying your base coats, try to be as neat as possible because this will help to make your model look really good. Also, when moving on from the metallic paints, just remember to change your water pot because you don't want to get any of those metallic flakes into the rest of your paints. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Lieutenant Castus from Combat Arena Clash of Champions. And we look forward to seeing you again soon. Goodbye.